In this video, we're going to learn how to derive the reduction formula for the integrand of the form of sine x raised to the nth power dx. So notice that if you try to use integration by parts, you will be partially correct because that's what you have to use. But if you use the u for the sine x to the nth power and the dv for the dx, you will fail because basically you will basically go you won't make a loop, you will just go halfway and then return, because it's not going to get you anywhere. You will have 0 is equal to 0 on both sides. Okay, however, you can make this look like this. You can reduce the power and split this term. Make it sine to the n negative 1 x multiplied by sine x dx, right? Because if you multiply these back, you will get sine x raised to the power of n minus 1 plus 1, which is equal to sine x to the nth power. Now you can use the u and du and the dv, right? You can still use integration by parts. So if you use u is equal to sine n minus 1 x, right? Then the du will be n minus 1 brought down, right? Sine, and the power decreases, right? So it becomes n minus 2x, and then the derivative of the inside, right, which is the cosine x and also the dx, right? Now the dv obviously is going to be sine x dx, right? And the v, of course, is going to be negative cosine x. So now we're going to have uv, right? So it's going to be minus sine x to the n minus 1 power times cosine x minus v du. Minus with this minus gives you a plus, so plus n minus 1, let's put it outside because that's a constant, sine to the n minus 2 x times cosine squared x, right? Because there's a cosine twice here. Now notice that you can substitute this cosine squared using the identity, right? Which means that cosine squared x is equal to 1 minus sine squared x, right? So we can have it written as, I'm going to write the integral again, sine n x dx is equal to negative sine x to the n minus 1 power cosine x plus n minus 1 sine to the sine x to the n minus second power times 1 minus sine squared x dx, right? And that's going to give us negative sine x to the n minus 1 power times cosine of x plus n minus 1 integral sine x to the n minus second power, right, times 1, we're going to split this integral, minus n minus 1 sine x raised to the nth power, right, because sine squared x times sine x to the n minus second power is sine x to the nth power, and that's exactly what you want, because now you can add this integral to the left side, right, you could add it on both sides like that, okay, and as a result you will have n minus, the coefficient of this integral will be n minus 1 plus 1, right, which means that it's going to be n integral sine n x dx is equal to negative sine x to the n minus 1 power times cosine of x plus n minus 1 coefficient integral sine x to the n minus second power dx, right? So all that remains to do now is to simply divide this integral, because you're treating this integral as a variable, right? So you're going to divide it by n now, and then that solves for it, all right? So it's going to be, so this coefficient is negative 1, so it's going to be negative 1 over n, because you're dividing everything by n, right? Sine n negative 1 x cosine of x plus n minus 1 divided by n, there's a fraction as a coefficient now, integral of sine x to the n minus second power dx. And guess what this means? This means that putting this coefficient aside, this constant coefficient, you can use the reduction formula that we've just derived, treating this integral as a new term from which you're going to use the reduction. Okay, so basically you're going to treat the n minus 2 as a new n from which you will also derive the same first term, and then the integral after that as well. Okay? So it just goes infinitely. It just goes n minus 2. Then obviously you will have n minus 4 after that, right, in your integral. And then you will have n minus 6 and so on and so on, right? So however, the number of times that you will have this integral raised to the power 2 below the previous one will be based on the value of n, right? How large it is. So the larger the n, the more integrals like this you're going to deal with, and the more terms you're going to have, obviously. But this is how this reduction formula is derived. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you in my next video. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.